Welcome back to the Quadrant II organizing series, where we are discussing a new functional planning technique that comes from the book First Things First. And if you haven't watched the first episode yet where we covered step number one, I'll link it below so you can catch up and then come back to this video. I'm so sick of waiting. In step two, we are going to identify our roles in life, because the authors say a clear set of roles provides a natural framework to create order and balance. And we will use that framework to guide the planning process that we will cover in future steps. So ask yourself, in your life, what different hats do you wear and responsibilities do you have? For example, maybe you are a parent, a mentor, an employee, a volunteer, a student, or a caregiver. Start by taking out a sheet of paper and brain dumping what you think your life roles are. You could even include a role category called individual, which the authors say that you can include if you'd like to work on things like personal development or hobbies. After writing all of that down, circle between 1 to 4 of the roles that you want to start with. Although the book does say that you can choose up to 7 roles, I just think that we should start small and then add more roles later once you feel more comfortable with this technique. According to the book First Things First, balance among roles does not simply mean that you're spending time in each role, but that these roles work together for the accomplishment of your mission. When you are thinking about what your roles are, think about what roles will help you to make your mission statement into a reality. Part of my mission statement that I completed in the first video is to support and love my husband, family, and friends well. So I circled spouse because I want to improve my relationship with my husband. I can also honor my commitments that I've made to my boss, my colleagues, by working on my roles as lab manager and researcher. So I circled those. And I also want to serve others. So in addition to volunteering, I'm trying to provide helpful content through this YouTube channel. So I circled that as well. I decided to address my role of being a Christian under the Sharpen the Saw section, and we'll discuss what that section is and how it works during the next video in this series. Next, you can write down your roles in your sidebar, leaving space in between each role, and we'll be filling that out in the next step. So now we get into the Quadrant 2 organizing, which is this weekly kind of appointment that you make with yourself. It takes about 30 minutes to complete the entire process per week, according to the authors. You choose a Quadrant 2 goal for each of your roles. A Quadrant 2 goal refers to a task that falls under Quadrant 2 of Stephen Covey's time management matrix. This matrix is divided into 4 categories depending on whether or not they are important and urgent. Quadrant 1 tasks are important and urgent, such as projects with deadlines or a medical emergency, signing paperwork for your child's school, fixing a broken washing machine, essentially anything that has a due date, but it's also important to you. The authors describe how it's not necessarily bad to be in Quadrant 1, but you don't want to be consumed with just focusing on urgent tasks. You also want to plan in Quadrant 2 tasks, which are both important and not urgent. Examples of these are personal growth activities, taking time to plan, self-care, spending time with friends and family in an effort to improve that relationship, taking preventative measures like home maintenance. And then in Quadrant 3, we get to the not important but urgent tasks, like unnecessary emails, unnecessary phone calls, and unnecessary meetings. Or if someone tries to get you to solve their problem for them when they could easily just do it themselves. These are tasks that don't require your specific skill set, and they can be delegated to others. The not important but not urgent activities in Quadrant 4 are things like binge watching Netflix or scrolling through social media sites and busy work. You really want to reduce these activities as much as possible because they are considered to be time wasters. To choose your Quadrant 2 goals, the authors recommend asking yourself, what is the most important thing I can do in each role this week to have the greatest positive impact? And you want to select goals for yourself that are both important and not urgent. So for example, my Quadrant 2 goal for my role as a spouse is to spend quality time with my husband by going kayaking, since it's something that we both enjoy. And for my role as a content creator for YouTube, I want to film and edit 2 videos so I can start to build up a video library of content. These are important, but not necessarily urgent, and they help me to move closer towards some of the goals that I've set for myself. Today, we covered the steps associated with choosing your roles and setting your Quadrant 2 goals. In the next video, which is the last video in this series, we'll cover the final 7 steps of Quadrant 2 organizing. And if you want to be notified when that video is posted, you can sign up for my mailing list using the link that I've included in the description. And I'll see you next Saturday. Bye. So let go. I don't want to, but I'm gonna try. When she left me, yeah, died a little bit inside. You know, maybe things are gonna be alright. 'Cause I just wanna see the light. I just wanna